Well, here you see all the parts for the laser cannons. There's nothing in particular to note here, except there's four of everything. Here we have the laser cannon mounting plates, which get put on the wings first, and then the laser cannons added to them. And then those little tiny things I call the laser cannon bumps. These tiny parts get put on last, as you can, and you can see where they go on the side of the laser cannon here. However, the one that's on the laser cannon is actually an older part, and it's molded in place, but it's backwards. So don't put it on like that. On our finished part here, you can see the laser cannon sitting on the mounting plate. The mounting plate is glued into place on the end of the wing. Somewhat in this position here, though I'll show you the exact alignment later. Now here we have the laser cannon barrel. This is a brass tube that's been molded into the polyurethane barrel. The heatsink part fits over the barrel and sits up against the base, and that base fits right inside the end of the body that you see here. You want to clean the flash out of this end of the laser cannon body, which you can do with a fingernail. Now, this plug fits inside the laser cannon body, just like this. And the only thing you want to watch out for is that on the heatsink, there are these two little fins that are odd from the rest of them, and that these two little vanes on the body should line up, just like that. Now, this is the end cap for the laser cannons, and this is a bad part, by the way, just for this video. It simply fits into the end of the laser cannon body, and it sticks out a certain distance. Each X-wing was different in this respect, and that's about how far it should be. Now, here I'm cleaning up one of the rings that fits onto the heatsink part of the laser cannon. You want to use a file that's round on one side and flat on the other. This way you can avoid creating flat spots in the part while you're sanding it. The part sands very easily. The flash isn't difficult to get off. Unfortunately, most of my parts don't have flash, but some of them have a little tiny amount, and this is the price we pay for building resin kits. This is the little crescent part that fits on the end of the laser cannon. As you can see, it's got flash all over it. So we'll just file it off here, I tell you. These resin kits, man, what a bitch to put together. You have to I'm sorry. Anyway, just file the stuff off and this part turns out beautifully each and every time. See? Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Okay, enough frivolity. So, you take the ring, you slip it over the barrel and onto the heat sink. And you position it so you've got about a 16th or just between a 16th and an 8th of an inch exposed, and you want to make sure that ring's on squarely, because otherwise it's crooked. So just straighten it up and it'll look great, just like that. Now for the most tedious part, the laser cannon bump. Stab your X-Acto knife into this part and you'll be able to position it just like that. To do that, you have to have a drop of glue. This is a Pringles cap, and you put a drop of glue in it, and you just touch the part to the glue. Just touch it, barely touch it, and then just come over here and touch it to the surface, and bingo, you're done. That part's stuck. See? Pretty good, huh? Okay, now we're going to stick the button on, and to do that, we're putting a little gap-filling glue there. And then the button fits over that, and it'll squish the glue down. Now the important thing you got to do here is you have to get this thing on squarely, so when you rotate the barrel, it doesn't wobble. If it does wobble, break it free and clean it off and start over again, but you want to get this thing on squarely. Now we're going to put another drop of glue on, and this is going to hold the crescent piece in place. I have no idea what to call this thing. There's supposed to be a hole cast into it. If it's closed up, just open it up with your X-Acto knife, and it fits on the end like that. Now we're going to put on the laser cannon mounting plate. And this thing fits in that area you can see that is outlined like right there. That dark area, the reflection where it's dark, is where this piece fits. just fits right on there, and that's molded onto your wing. You'll be able to see it. Anyway, hold the piece in position, and then dip your knife blade in some glue, just like I'm doing here, and run it along the joint between the two parts, and the glue will creep right inside there. This is thin glue, by the way, thin super glue, and the stuff just creeps right into the smallest of cracks. Okay, that part is now mounted. It's solid, it ain't going nowhere. To mount the laser cannon, you gotta align these three pins, but it's only the first one that you need to worry about. It fits up against that reveal there. So the most important thing here is you want to make sure that the side of the laser cannon is pointing directly outward. So we put a couple of drops of glue in the saddle, and later on we'll add them to the pegs after the laser cannon has been glued in place. You want to make sure that the pegs have been glued on as well. That really holds the sucker on there. These parts are the detail parts that are on the rear of the wings underneath the engines. And they are matched up in pairs, just like this. This is as if we were looking at the rear end of the ship. You can see how the top half is a pair and the bottom half is a pair. This is how they align with the wing. And this is how it aligns with the other wing, the lower wing. And this is how they align when you have the wings in the closed position.